What's good, y'all? Welcome to my review for my review on the Microsoft E3 press conference, as well as Bethesda. Bethesda ain't getting their video this year again because they show next to nothing, or what they did show, I gave zero fucks about, because it's literally just Elder Scrolls and Doom. There was some good stuff there, I won't lie, there was a couple stuff about Bethesda, which we will talk about later on, but overall, Bethesda, yeah, this ain't it, Chief. This ain't it. Anyway, all they were concerned about was like, hey, we fucked up, we'll do better, you know, that was Bethesda. Anyway, so let me just jump right into everything that got revealed at Microsoft's press conference. Got this article from Kotaku on my phone here. Yes, I know, you're probably like, oh, I was using Kotaku, and Kotaku's like, I don't care who's got this, I just need something just to make sure I got everything, or at least I got the major stuff I want to talk about, because they showed off 60 games, last year they showed off 50, and a lot of them did look pretty good. But a lot of them I just did not care about, like the plane simulator. Who the fuck asked for this? Yes, I would love to play a plane simulator. Can I? Oh, wait. Never mind. No. I was about to make a really edgy joke. And I shall refrain from making that edgy joke. I will let y'all use your imagination to go with my edgy joke about planes. What you could probably guess. Anyway. But overall, I would say Microsoft did a good job. They showed off a lot of great games. A lot of good stuff. And, yeah. So, without further ado, we'll just kind of go through this article, and I'll just tell you guys some of my major high points about this. So, the first thing we got here is they announced a new console, or showed it off. It's called Project Scarlet, or that's the code name right now, just like, you know, the Xbox One S was Project Scorpio when that first got announced. I honestly could not tell you anything about this console, because I do not speak techno-mumble-jumble bullshit. I heard, oh yeah, we're going to be using SSDs for it to make extra RAM, and I'm like, this is 3 times more powerful than the Xbox One X. And so wait, instead of 6 teraflops, we have 21 teraflops. Holy fuck, this is a literal god. All sarcastic, I did not understand half of it, but I will say, did you all notice the way how they handled the women in this trailer? And that little demonstration, you were like, you might wonder, oh, what the hell are you talking about women? Exactly. They do not be like, oh, look how diverse our team is, you know. They showed off women, but they just showed them off as no other than just other devs. Thank you, Microsoft. Crunchyroll, take notes. Just saying. Anyway. Oh, and they also said that Halo Infinite will be the launch title alongside, so just like the original Xbox. Halo will be that system seller. That game right there waiting for you to play. Just like Breath of the Wild was for the Nintendo Switch. You guys know I love Halo. Big fan of Halo. But for God's sakes, Halo 5 is my fucking intro. You know, I love me some Halo. The Halo theme is the greatest video game theme of all time. Do not fucking at me. I do not care. That theme is God. I love it. Every time I was listening to that theme a lot today. After when I saw Halo Infinite, I just felt like re-listening to that theme, man. Man, it's been years sometimes I've seen that game. Anyway. So I'm hyped. They got to show up a little demo. They show up a little cinematic trailer for the game. No gameplay, unfortunately, but I'm hyped. I love me some Halo, and I look forward to seeing the latest adventure of the Master Chief. So that's going to be cool. Let's see what else we got here. We got Cyberpunk 2077. I'm really hyped for this game. This game looks like it's going to be really good. I've never played anything from CG Projekt Red, but I lost my shit when I saw my man Keanu Reeves, Mr. Wick himself. How can I help you today, Mr. Wick? Y'all know, it wasn't too long ago I saw John Wick Chapter 3. Fucking masterpiece of a film. If you have not seen John Wick Chapter 3, for the love of God, get off your ass and watch the fucking movie. After you watch Godzilla, then go watch John Wick. And Endgame. Watch the Endgame first, then Godzilla, then go watch John Wick Chapter 3. Parabellum. Anyway. And we also did get it, so I love when Keanu came out there humble, being like, hi everyone, you know, he's like, yo, you're a thing of beauty and everything. I love Keanu Reeves, man. And I just love the fact he's also an otaku as well. That's just the icing on the cake that is Keanu Reeves, man. Kind of wish he was playing Spike Spiegel in the new Cowboy Bebop live-action series Netflix is doing, because I feel like he would just be perfect for that role. But alas, we will not have Keanu Reeves. Anyway. So we also got a release date for the game coming out on April 16th, 2020. So the game looks great. We also got some new news about new devs, Microsoft Bot. They got Double Fine Productions, the guys behind Psychonauts, is now part of Xbox. Cool. Show us some new stuff for Gears 5. It's going to come out September 10th. Looks good. It's not as impressive as it was last year. Last year they showed off a lot more gameplay. This, they just kind of showed off a couple modes. That's about it. I mean, they even had my man, the phenomenal AJ Styles, where there was Xavier Woods as well as Tyler Breeze. They were waiting to play the game, but they said that was gonna be like on their mixer thing. So maybe that gameplay will come out, or maybe it'll be up on Xavier's YouTube channel, up, up, down, down. So we might see that gameplay of that new mode called, I forget what it was called, Hunt Mode or something. I don't know. I don't really remember. I'm surprised they didn't get my man Kenny Omega in there. Omega? How about you give me some more, Why did I do that, man? Nobody is... Only like two people are going to get that joke. Why did I even bother doing my man JD? Anyway. Yeah. Anyway, guys, so Gears 5 is coming out. That looks pretty cool. I like this game. This game looks pretty good from what I've seen of it. I like how this is like, I like how they're gone a lot more Frozen with this game. I've never played any of the Gears games, so I don't know if I can even jump right into this without ever playing any of the other Gears games. I'm sure someone's like, no, play all three, play all the Gears game. I don't know. Also, guys, I want to ask you guys a question. Is it even worth me getting an Xbox One X at this point? Because we know that the Project Scarlet is going to be coming out in 2020, holiday 2020. So I want, because I do want to get an Xbox One X just so I can play a lot of the games I miss, like Halo 5, play the Master Chief Collection, Forza Horizon 4, a lot of games I miss from the Xbox One because I've been playing solely on PlayStation this whole generation. So yeah, I want to ask you guys: do you think it's even worth me getting an Xbox One X at this point, or should I just wait till Project Scarlet comes out? Tell me that down below. I want to know what you guys think about that. Anyway. So we got Gears 5, they also announced a new an Elite Controller Series 2, they also announced a Sega's online RPG, Phantasy Star Online 2, which for some reason it's spelled with a PH instead of an F. Don't know why Sega decided to be like, oh yeah, let's change it to an F, to a PH instead of an X, because fuck it. Anyway, so that's online, is going to be coming to the West on Xbox One and PS and PC. Surprise, PlayStation isn't getting any love there. Because when it comes to anime in Japan in general, PlayStation's all over that shit. But okay, Microsoft's trying to make their way in Japan. Or at least trying to. But okay. So, I've never played this game before. I'm not really into MMOs. They just can't keep my attention. So, yeah. The new Tales game also got announced. Tales of Arise coming out 2020. Never played any of the Tales game. Played the demo of Vesperia, the latest one. This game looks really cool. I like my JRPGs, but yeah, this game looks pretty cool. In my personal opinion, anyway. They also announced Elden Ring. This is a collaboration between From Software, the guys behind Dark Souls, as you guys know, and of course, the writer of Game of Thrones, George R.R. Martin. So, yeah. Get hyped for all you Game of Thrones people. For all you Game of Thrones people out there. Battletoads is back, and they had the... They went back... Like, Battletoads actually started off E3. I love how they That's my attempt at that little song there. Like, I love that song. It's so fucking catchy. That beat's so catchy. Yeah. They announced the Flight Simulator. Who the fuck asked for this? This? Who wants a flight simulator? Like, who's even into that shit? I don't know. That just kind of seems kind of stupid to me, but... Hey, for all you peeps out there that like your planes, here you go. Yes. The anime game that got announced here. Now, I mentioned now, you guys now... Now, if you guys follow me on Twitter, I was like... And also, you guys saw my E3 predictions video. You guys know... the anime game I said was probably either going to be Project Z, a new Naruto game, or, as I said there, wishful thinking, a new Bleach game. I went so off hoping it was Bleach that I even wore my Bleach pants while I was watching the press conference, which you guys will see when my reaction drops, hopefully tomorrow. It might end up being a little bit later than that, just because of how everything. I still got to watch Attack on Titan tomorrow. You got Ubisoft and Square Enix. So, yeah. Hopefully I'll be able to get my reactions out not too long. You guys get to check them out for you guys. I want to check those out. I'm gonna talk a little bit more about Kakarot, which we got the official name, Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. I swear, as the Toriyama gets older, he's acting more and more like Vince McMahon, pushing Goku like Roman Reigns here. Like, I don't know how much I don't know if Toriyama just is loving Goku that much more as he gets older, or this is a way to be like, ah, we need our Babe Ruth. Give me more Goku. Oh yes, we need more Goku. Fuck Ichigo and those guys. All we want is Goku. You know, like, you got all these other characters in here, Shueisha. Why you gotta focus this on so you just keep pushing Goku? Okay, yeah, Goku's the OG, but you got Ichigo, Naruto, Kakashi, Soma, my man Izuku, Asta. Who else? Who else we got? The guys from Haikyuu. What's her name from The Promised Neverland? Shit, her name's slipping my mind. Shit! I can't remember her name. But if you guys watch The Promised Neverland, you know I'm talking about the girl with the orange hair. That's way too naive for her own good. Her name is that's gonna piss me off. But I'll talk more about Dragon Ball Z Kakarot a little bit like around when we get to around the end of the press conference. Let me see if there's anything else here I want to talk about. New game from Ninja Theory, Bleeding Edge, don't really care. Minecraft Dungeons! You can hear the excitement in my voice. Do not care. We saw more from Jedi Fallen Order. This was more like a little bit of extra gameplay, but mostly just a little edited version of the gameplay we saw at EA Play yesterday. We got a little bit like we saw him. We saw what's the dude's name? Crap! I forgot the kids. But the guy that the MC for the game, we saw him swimming around, climbing on some AT-ATs. Looked really cool, and you guys know I'm excited for Jedi Fallen Order in November. Hyped as hell, I cannot wait to play that. It also looks like my dream Star Wars game, honestly. They also announced a new Blair Witch. There is actually going to be a Blair Witch game. Interesting. Okay. Blair Witch. No other stuff like Age of Empire, Definitive Edition. I don't care. This one got me. So Forza Horizon 4 came with the new LEGO expansion. I love me some Legos, and I love Forza Horizon, man. I played a little bit the first game back on the 360, man. I really dig those games. I really dig the Forza Horizon games, man. This is just me. This just took a smile on my face. And what really got me to lose my shit is that we also got announced of a new Lego Star Wars game. It's called Lego Star Wars: The Skywalker Saga, which will be tackling all 9 episodes of Star Wars done in Lego form. So I don't know if they're going to be redoing episodes 1 through 6, because they already got that done during the Complete Saga, which was released years ago. I don't know if they're going to be reworking those games, they're going to remaster. Like, I'm pretty sure they're going to remaster them for Xbox One, but I don't know if they're going to, like, completely remake them, like, you know, add new cutscenes with the voice acting and everything, or they're going to leave them as the original ones when they were released back when Lego was still not doing the whole voice acting thing. I don't know, but I'm hyped, because I love Lego Star Wars. I've always been a fan of Lego Star Wars, and I can't wait to play it. I'm very much curious what they're going to do with The Last Jedi, since The Last Jedi is the worst movie of all time, and it ruined Star Wars. Rian Johnson raped my childhood. You know. You guys already know how much of The Last Jedi. So, yeah. Let's see if there's anything else. A bunch of indie games. Let's see. Yeah, that's about it. They announced a bunch of games. I know I missed a lot of them, but 60 games, most of them I do not care about. They showed some new stuff for Ori and the Will of the Winds. Looks cool. I like the design of Ori. They also announced that Skull Knight, I think that game was called, is going to be coming to Game Pass. They also announced another stuff for Game Pass. They also announced a PC version of Game Pass and the Ultimate Game Pass, which has for Xbox One, Gold, Membership, as well as PC, $14.99 a month, I'm assuming. So, yeah. Now, this is going to take up most of the video, probably, or at least a decent chunk here. Let me talk about Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. Now, as we know, this game is going to be developed by CyberConnect 2, which you guys know were the guys behind Storm Games. I played a little bit of the Storm Games. I actually got Storm 3 on my PS3. I like the Storm Games. From what I played the demo of Storm 4, what I played of Storm 3, and some of the demos of the other games, I really dig the Storm Games. I think the gameplay is great. The presentation is fucking phenomenal. It looks just like the anime, man. And you guys know how much I love me some Naruto. And now, we didn't get much from the trailer itself. We saw a little bit of gameplay. The game looks like FighterZ, but in 3D. which I love, because I love, absolutely fucking loved the presentation of FighterZ. It looked like the anime. You got that all that epic presentation there with the fights and everything that Arc System Works did. And it looks like Siege, and also it looks like Cyber Connect 2 is going to be taking that and putting it to in 3D. It kind of, the fighting, from what I saw of it, looks a little bit more like Budokai Tenkaichi than, I guess, Xenoverse. Maybe it kind of looks a little bit more like Budokai Tenkaichi, in my personal opinion. Or maybe, or honestly, it definitely feels like it probably does feel, probably when you play it, probably does going to feel like the Storm games. But it looks amazing. It looks just like where it should be from Dragon Ball. It's visceral. It's high octane from the little. And we also got some extra gameplay that IGN dropped from, you know, their little play there, which I saw Afro's video on it. The extra gameplay looks amazing. I cannot wait to play this, man. This game looks like everything I want in a Dragon Ball game. It has amazing presentation. Looks just like FighterZ with, like, you know, the presentation, the art style, and everything. It looks just like FighterZ, which I love. You guys know how much I love the presentation for FighterZ. It looks like that. The gameplay looks fucking phenomenal. It looks like it's going to be amazing. Hopefully, the story mode, you get to play around with other characters. Like, I would love to play around with my man Vegeta, or my man, my brother, my dude, Gohan. Y'all better not disrespect my man Gohan in this game, because my man Gohan was a beast in the beta for FighterZ. Ultimate Gohan, whoo, man, I was Tony News with my man Gohan there. So y'all better not disrespect my man Gohan in the game, or I'm going to come after you. Anyway, it looks like it'll probably just be Z, no super character. They might get added as DLC. If they do, give me Goku Black. I just want Goku Black. So, yeah, the game looks amazing, and I'm definitely super excited to play Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. It looks like everything I want in a Dragon Ball Z game. And it's an action RPG. It looks kind of open world-ish, or at least they have big hub worlds, which they look great, man. And I just can't wait to play it. It's like, a Dragon Ball Z RPG definitely intrigues me, because if any anime can support that, it's Dragon Ball Z and probably a few other animes. You could probably make... there's a lot of animes for that from Shonen Jump that you could make into action RPGs, but Dragon Ball is definitely one big one, which is what you could do a lot. And we've had some back in the day, during the like Super Nintendo days, they had a lot of action RPGs for Dragon Ball Z, but this year we got this one, New Gen Con, PS4 and Xbox One. Got 3D done by Cyber Connect 2, a dev that's known to be doing some pretty good games with the Ninja Storm games. Anyway, they seem to be. I'm pretty sure all the Ninja Storm games have been pretty well received, as far as I know. Right? I don't pay time. I haven't been paying attention that much to the Ninja Storm stuff. But anyway, I'm hyped for the game. Tell me down below, guys, what you guys think of Dragon Ball FighterZ. Are you excited? Or not FighterZ. For Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. Are you excited? Do you not like how the Goku's getting top bill in the title? You would prefer it with something else? Anyway, tell me all that down below, guys, what you guys thought of Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. I'm excited for the game. It looks like it's going to be fucking amazing. In my personal opinion, anyway. So, let's get to Bethesda. They showed nothing. They showed up nothing but Elder Scrolls, and Elder Scrolls. Show us a new stuff for Fallout 77, for Fallout 78, 76. Don't really care. They announced the game's going to be going free-to-play all next week, or all this week. So, yeah, I don't care. Maybe I might play it, just for fucks, just for shits and giggles. But, yeah, I wasn't impressed by Bethesda. Bethesda damn near bored me to tears. The stuff with Doom was pretty cool, and that new game they announced, what was that game from Japan? That game looked really nice. I like that. That one actually looked really cool. What was it called? Ghostwire Tokyo, that's what the game called. Now, this one's actually done by the creator of Resident Evil, Shinji Mikami, so I actually didn't know that. Look at this. The game looks really cool. We don't really know much of the game, and I couldn't really tell that much from the presenter, Shinji Mikami, or as well as that cute girl that was right there, like, I won't lie, that Japanese girl that was there with her that also did some presenting, she's really cute. I need to look her up, find her on Twitter, and follow her on Twitter and Instagram. Anyway, but like I mentioned, she was really cute. But enough of me talking about my taste in females. She was cute, though. I won't lie, she was cute. Anyway, the game looks amazing. It looks really, really cool from what we saw from the trailer, and I'm definitely looking forward to seeing more of Ghostwire. There was another game called Deathloop that also got announced there, which was pretty cool. Looks really good. looks really, really good. I'm definitely excited for this game. And I love the devs. They came out there and they were just saying fucking a lot. Like, he said, like, yeah, this game looks really fucking cool. And the other one was like, yeah, it is fucking cool. And it was like, it was just amazing. I got a good laugh out of that one. I got a good laugh out of it. That was about it. They announced for new games, showed off some new stuff for Doom Eternals. Looked pretty cool. New Wolfenstein game, Youngblood. Don't really care. So, yeah. So let's get to my final verdicts. For Microsoft, I will give them an 8.5 out of 10 because of what they showed up with Keanu Reeves and also Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. Looked amazing. Only problem I had with the Dragon Ball Z Kakarot trailer was that it was with the Japanese audio, the Japanese cast, not the English dub. I'm sorry, but you guys know me. I don't like the Japanese audio. It's just me. I'm sorry. I got nothing but respect for the Japanese cast, but I just prefer Sean Schimmel, Chris Sabath. Those are my guys. Anyway, so, yeah. Then I give them an 8.5 out of 10. Bethesda, I'll give them a 6. It was okay, but, I mean, I'm sure if you were an Elder Scrolls fan, that is your shit. This was perfect for you. You probably got a lot more enjoyment out of this than I did. I was pretty much bored to fucking tears. But that's just my personal opinion. So anyway, guys, tell me down below what y'all thought of these press conferences. Are you, like me, desperately missing Sony's presence here? Because, God, do we need them? But who knows? We got Square Enix. I think they're going to win E3 this year. If they come out swinging with Final Fantasy VII Remake, which you know is going to come out in March 30th next year. So fucking hyped for that. We got the Avengers Project as well. And Ubisoft is going to come out there with Watch Dogs Legion. I'm hyped for Ubisoft and Square Enix. They're going to come out swinging. But yeah, tell me all that down below, guys, what you guys thought of these press conferences. Did you love them? Did you hate them? Were you bored to tears? Do you think Microsoft's going to end up winning? Or Bethesda? Tell me all that down below, guys. And so yeah, I'm going to end it here, guys. Hope you all enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter if you like it. Links down in the description box below. And as always, come back for more. See you guys next time.